Happy Saturday, you guys. Happy birthday, Mike Dean. Hopefully your day starts off super awesome because you're starting with this, hopefully. Anyway, yes, happy birthday, Mike. Enjoy your day. Today we have a cool on the minute leading into another on the minute, but we'll get to that momentarily. We're gonna talk about our warm up quick. We'll take you through a quick head to toe body wake up with myself and Raquel. We're then gonna move into some single leg and some squat warm up stuff. So we're gonna work through single leg reach back for five aside, into a single leg bridge for five aside, bridge hold, so 2 feet, 10 to 20 seconds, and just kind of bringing everything together and balancing out the hips. Dynamic triangle for five aside, and a sumo squat for five reps at a 3 second down, no pause, and 3 second up. So a little slow down, turn around, come back up the same speed, all right? 2 to 3 rounds, just kind of waking things up, make sure the hips are ready to go in all shapes and sizes of that, and every area of the hip is ready for this work set today. After that, we have some dynamic stuff. We're gonna work on the drop squats. We're gonna work on pulling ourselves down quickly, holding the bottom position for a couple seconds so we can work on our balance. All right, so 3 to 5 reps of the drop squat, 2 second hold the bottom. Tempo jump squat, so we're just gonna play around with a slower pull down of the squat, hold for a second, then drive into that jump or into a more aggressive stand if you don't want to jump. So have 2 reps of that, and then you're gonna work on a single leg RDL jump for 5 reps per side. So a little bit of dynamic stuff, a little bit of jumping with a single leg. And again, for some of you, if you're like, hey, don't think I've done that one before, we've done it a couple times, so we'll review it with you guys on this one just to make sure you're comfortable with it. Then we're gonna slow things down, lay on the floor for a while, and just work on those shoulders and work on that humeral glide to knee push-up for 3 to 5 reps to kind of prime you up for what's to come, all right? So 3 to 5 rounds there. Getting into our work set, what we have for you guys, 3, 2, 1, go. You'll have it on the minute for 6 minutes to do first. So minute number one, you will do max rep jump squat or air squat for 30 seconds. Minute number two, you will do max rep push-up for the whole minute. And then you'll come back to minute number one, back to the max rep jump squat for 30 seconds. So you'll always have 30 seconds of rest moving into the push-up, all right? So keep that in mind, and then you'll hit that minute number two max rep push-up. So you'll do 3 rounds of that top piece first, then you'll go right into the next one. So no gap after that, so we go from our third round of push-ups. On the next beat, we move into minute number one down here, max rep jumping lunge, or lunge for 30 seconds. Then you'll have 30 seconds of rest before we move into minute number two, which is max rep burpee for the full minute. All right, then you're gonna take that down for 3 rounds, and then you're done, all right? Done and done, all right? So we get some nice solid dynamic squatting and dynamic lunging, followed up with a little bit of strong strength pushing, and then some dynamic pushing here as well. All right, so we'll walk you through that. We'll get you comfortable with the movements coming your way, and get you ready. All right, you guys, let's do this up. Let's warm you guys up a little bit. Let's get those feet under the hips. Take the arms big and tall overhead. You're just gonna stretch it over to one side. We'll come back to center, stretch it to the other side. Come back up, and then forward fold. So we'll touch those toes. Walk with those shins. We're gonna come back down, plant both hands, step back into our plank. Set those shoulders, set those hips, and then press back into our down dog. In this down dog, making sure the shoulders are set, we should walk our heels just a few times back and forth. Nothing too aggressive. Hold even for a beat. Just nice wake up of those ankles and feet. From here, we'll balance it out, one more per side. We'll come back into our plank. We'll step that left foot up. We're gonna take that inside hand onto that front foot, locking those legs in place. We're gonna turn our torso to the outside hand. We'll come back to center, turn the torso, come back to center, and turn the torso, and back to center. We're gonna lower the knee. We're gonna plant the hand on the floor, press the hip, come back to center, and slowly straighten the front leg as best you can. Come back to plant the foot, press the hip, come back to center, slowly straighten that front leg to the best of your ability. Come back down one more time, press the hip to center, slowly straighten that leg
to your down dog again and reaching those hips high. Set the shoulders and walk those heels out again. Nice and slow. Keeping those shoulders nice and strong. We'll balance out those feet one more per side. We'll come back into our plank. Stepping that other foot up. Inside hands are going to lock and load on that foot and then turn the torso. Come back to center. Turn the torso. Back to center. And turn the torso. Back to center. Plant the hand on the floor. Lower the back knee. We'll press the hip. Come back to center. Keeping that front leg straight. Hip square. Let's straighten that front leg. Come back to center. Press the hip. Center, straighten as best you can, just the first sensation. Plant the foot, press the hip to center. One more time, straighten that front leg as best you can, and then plant that foot. Straighten up the back leg, step back into that down dog. One last set of heel presses. You're gonna walk those feet out nice and slow, stable through those shoulders, nice and active through the upper body. Good. We'll balance it out. We'll find our plank. And then keep in that strong shoulder position. Keep pressing through as we tiptoe those feet up. And then we're going to roll ourselves up. Big tall stretch. Clasp those fingers. Press way up and reach. And reach. Bring those hands down. Let's keep you guys going, all right? If you'd like to warm up a little bit more, pause the video. Come back to us. We're going to start going through that lower body kind of stability work set. So what we're going to do for Raquel, she's going to get set up in the middle. She's going to work through her single leg reach back. So she's going to pick the foot that she would like to use first, and she's going to try and stay as stable over top of that leg as she can. So finding her point of balance, that foot nice and flat. She's going to reach her arms forward as she extends the leg back, but keeping her center mass over top of this balancing leg, and then come back up. And then she'll reach lower down as deep as she feels comfortable, maintaining that midfoot balance, and then coming tall. And again, as she gets her last rep in here, Raquel's going to reach and reach that leg back. That toe might touch, but again, we're not dedicating our weight back here. We're keeping it square. Okay, just turn it away. Do the other leg. So again, actually, I'm going to turn face the camera. So from here, with the other leg, we're going to get a chance to get Raquel to do a bunch of circles for us, and then she's gonna, I want you to pay attention to her position. So again, nothing really changes in the lower half of the body, but I want you to watch her torso position.
Bad leg.
That's okay. So her body is gonna stay nice and square. So the biggest thing I want you guys to focus on is that she's not rotating, all right? So she's not catering to one side. She's staying nice and square with her body. Weight is still staying over top of that balancing leg, and that leg in the back is reaching back, touching down, but not dedicating any load back to it. So again, we just want to try and stay as square as we can, hips staying as square as we can as well. Okay. Our next exercise is a single leg bridge. So we're going to stick with the single leg stuff. The next two are going to be on the floor. So Raquel's going to get set up in her bridge position. Hands can be down the side for extra balance, especially with the single leg bridge. It might feel nicer to have the hands on the floor. It's up to you for that one. Raquel's going to pick a leg. She's going to pull that leg up off the floor. It can be bent. It can be straight on an angle. It can be straight up, whatever's more comfortable for you. And she's going to squeeze and lift that hip up as high as she can, keeping those hips square. Let's do 3%. So again, nice and smooth. She's not rushing through this movement. She's not pressing so much that she comes up onto her neck. Her shoulders and her foot are doing the work for her, okay? So that's her base of support, and she's squeezing and lifting. Again, both legs are not created equal on this because we do have imbalances in our body. So you might find that one side is a little stronger than the other, and that's okay. Just focus on keeping the hips square, the weight in the foot and in the shoulders so that you stay as safe as possible in that position. Her next exercise is going to be a bridge hold. So you could load this if you want. You don't have to, but you can. Either on the hip or straight above, like we have been in the past little while. She's going to lift up, squeezing the glutes. Again, her feet are going to be her base of support for the lower half, and her shoulders are her base of support here. And she's just going to keep squeezing those glutes and holding that strong position for 10 to 20 seconds. Okay? to toes. Her torso is nice and tall and upright, and she's working on. That's okay. We're holding pause.
3F.
3F. Yeah. Raquel likes pause squats, so that's all good. If you want to add a pause in there, you're more than welcome to. But again, we're working on paying attention to our depth here, because this sumo squat will allow you probably to get deeper, but we don't want to get deeper if we are losing position. So we want to make sure that we're maintaining that strong back angle and that she's only going down as far as she can maintain. Again, to a good visual for you guys, if you tend to have a little collapsing knee, imagine you put a band around your quads and you have to keep that band tight. Don't let the band get loose by pulling your knees in, press out, making sure those feet stay nice and flat. Okay, good reps. So as a quick recap, what we have, 2 to 3 rounds, single leg reach back for 5 per side, single leg bridge, 5 per side, into a bridge hold of 10 to 20 seconds, total count. If you would like to load that, you're more than welcome to. Dynamic triangle, 5 a side, if you want to load that too lightly, you can. And then a sumo squat for 5, 3 second down, 0 pause. If you want to add one in, be my guest, never deny that. And then 3 seconds stand up. Okay, so pause the video. You want to take those rounds down. Take them down, work on your skill, work on waking those legs up, because we want them ready for the work set. We're going to move into the next phase. So pause, rock it, come back to us. We're going to get these up, and they're going to get a little more dynamic. Okay, so we're going to start off with a drop squat. So a couple variations of the drop squat. We do these a lot with our Holy skill work, and this is a nice way to play without having to worry about a bar or a dumbbell or whatever we're playing around with. All right, I think we have to do these dumbbells that are kind of painful. But what Raquel is going to do is stand in her jumping stance, which is her hip width, or just outside of hip width. She's just going to be standing, ready to go, eyes straight ahead, weight through the midfoot. I'm going to show you something that tends to happen as you have a preemptive weight for that go. Sometimes we tend to lean into our toes as she waits for me to say the G word. Right? So we have to really fight to stay back in our midfoot, not too far back in our heels either. So when I say the G word, Raquel is going to pull herself down into that bottom of the squat, holding for 2 seconds to correct any balancing issues, and then stand. All right, you ready? All right, ready to go. Eyes straight ahead. Gangster. The original. Nice and solid, tall, and go! Nice. And then she stands. So that pause will give you a chance to fix any balance issues that you have from pulling. Alright, and that's something to keep in mind. Think about pulling down. Alright, ready to go. Go! Good. And then stand. So if you're going, Dave, like, I don't jump a lot and I don't like impact. It bugs my knees or I'm always falling over. Set yourself up in your squat stance. Same idea though. You're going to focus on that aggressive pull under. Aggressive is a relative term, so whatever you can control position. So her eyes are straight ahead, she's already in her squat stance, and I'll say, go! She'll pull herself down, nice and aggressive. Yeah, we'll do it. Hold for 2, and stand. That's okay. So, anyways. Eyes are straight ahead, we'll do one more. Again, there's no lifting of the feet, no finding stance, it's already there. She goes, go! And she pulls down. Good solid knees, good solid stance. She's working on that aggressive pull, right? You don't want to think about dropping down, even though that's the name. You want to think about pulling yourself into that squat position, okay? This next one, what we have is a tempo jump squat. And we're really just doing a tempo to load the proper position in the bottom, holding for a second, and then working the drive, okay? So a couple things you can play with this. We're just going to do one where you just land. So 5 second lower, 1 second pause, so she'll take it down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pause, and then she'll drive, and then she'll land, all right? The next one she's gonna take all the way down to the bottom, and she's gonna land in a little power position just so she's not dropping into a little squat. So she's gonna take it down, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pause, drive, and then she can stand up, reset, and then do the next rep. I offer a challenge to you though. So what Raquel is going to try and do, she hasn't done this yet. What
What she's going to try and do is she's going to do her 5 second lower. I'm not going to count for her. She's going to count her own time. 5 second lower, 1 second pause. She'll jump, and then she's going to land and move right into the next one at that 5 second tempo. So she's going to have to control her eccentric down on the bottom of the squat. It's extremely challenging to do. If you can't quite do the full 5 seconds, do what you can, but our goal is to slow herself down. Okay, so we'll let Raquel do 2 reps on her own at her own pace with a 5 down, 1 pause, drop. Okay? So as she's doing this, her position, her squat is exactly the same as it would be if she was doing an air squat, a back squat, whatever, all right, in terms of that position, her squat looks the same, right? And that was beautiful, all right? Beautiful work. So you saw her drive out of that squat as she landed, she kind of decelerated as she came down into the next squat. So you can do that too if you're comfortable with it. If not, just do the squat, land, reset, do the singles. Okay. If you're not comfortable with jump squats, we'll get her to do one more where she doesn't actually leave the ground. She's just gonna get a stand a little bit more aggressive, all right, and then pull back on her. So she gets her 5 second down, she gets her 1 second pause at the bottom, and then she's just gonna open and close. And then controls the down if you like, or do the singles. It's up to you in terms of how you want to take things down. Again, whatever is going to give you the most control of your movement, that's what we're after. Okay? So from there, what we have is our single leg RDL jump. So these are kind of fun. So for all of you who have kids in the program, this is basically the Mario jump. Alright, so we're working on the Mario jump, except we're sticking with one leg. So Raquel's going to load her leg that she's comfortable with. She's going to pull back into kind of a RDL position, and then she's going to drive up and then land. And then she's going to pull back into the next position, and then she's going to drive up and land. Okay? That's okay. Regardless, if the arm comes forward, because I've messed them up as well, preferably if we can get opposite arm to opposite leg that's doing the up, that's more kind of desirable because we get to work with opposite ends of our body in terms of rotation. But if the other arm goes, that's fine. I'm more concerned about the feet and the landing. Okay, so don't worry about how high you go. Worry about the balance, worry about the takeoff, and that landing position. Okay, if you don't feel comfortable jumping, Raquel's just going to do basically just a standing Mario jump. So she comes back, and she comes up with the knee, and comes back into the position. Okay, so if you don't want to jump, this is going to work and challenge your balance, and it's also going to work on delivering power through that single leg, even if you're not jumping. Okay? Our last exercise is a humeral glide knee push-up, 3 to 5 reps. She's going to get onto the floor position. So from here again, we've done these quite a bit, and I love watching the change these have created in your push-ups and your burpees. So Raquel's going to pull her shoulders forward. She's going to pull her shoulders back into that good set position. She's going to tuck and squeeze her ribs and hips together, maintaining that hollow. Then she's going to push into her push-up, just to the knees, maintaining that good, strong position. Everything moves together. She's going to maintain that position as she lowers down. So that knee, so that elbow position, stays stacked over top of the hand, and she gets a chance to relax at the bottom, reset the shoulders so where we don't want to go, to where we want them, tuck and stabilize, and then press up into that nice, solid knee push-up. Good. Everything comes up from knee to shoulder all at the same time, and then she's going to lower down. Same idea. Chest coming down first, and everything moving together. Okay? So one more time for everyone. Shoulders come forward. They come back. We reset the hip, and then we push, maintaining that good position, maintaining as we low down, we lower down. That's super important as well. Just because we get up, we still have to stay tight coming down. If you're not comfortable pushing up, or if you feel yourself snaking, that's okay. Do the shoulder, do the hip, and then you're just gonna isometric roll, press into the floor, coming up as high as you can maintain that position, hold for 3 to 5, and then lower. As a quick recap again for you guys for that work set, a little bit more dynamic. We have our drop squat, 3 to 5 reps, dropping down, holding for 2 seconds at the bottom, all right? Standing tall, then doing it again. Hear my voice in your mind going, go! All
yourself up, get ready.
I'm gonna walk you through the movements.
Okay. Our first exercise in the list is the jump squat. So again, we have a couple options for this. We have our jump squat, or we have our kind of aggressive squat without, just like we did in our warm-up, and or we have an air squat. So Raquel's just gonna demonstrate those for you again. There's no tempo on these, but I want you to stay controlled with your position. So Raquel's just gonna give us one good, actually two good jump squats. She squats down, good position. She controls her down. Again, just controlling her down enough that she can maintain a good squat position. So, height, not a big thing. Don't need to be super high trying to hit the ceiling. What we're looking for is that good, solid open of the hips and knees, and then find that good squat position. The other variation without leaving the ground, with that still aggressive turnover, Raquel will squat at a nice smooth pace. She'll open and close, but not actually leave the ground. You might find that the heels pop up a bit. That's fine, all right? Because it's just that hard extension of the knee and hip, pulling your heels off the ground. You don't have to really leave the ground, okay? Our last option for this is the air squat. So just a nice normal air squat. Again, working on good position, good key points of performance. So feet are just outside the shoulders, or at the shoulders. Knees are tracking those toes, and we're staying nice and upright. So if we'd like to use a target for this, please do so to keep yourself honest or hitting the range that you need to hit. Please do so, okay? Push-ups, all right? Love the push-up, all right? I'm just gonna do a couple of reps of each from the toes. Again, if you've been doing push-ups off of a counter, chair, couch, keep rocking, all right? Work on that range, work on that position. Raquel's gonna give us one solid toe push-up, all right? So she gets into her plank position, she's coming forward and down, and she creates that tripod. But again, you'll notice everything moves together, and she presses up. If you're like, I'm not quite there yet, but I can lower, she'll lower down through the toes, she'll drop to her knees, and press. Finish the rep up on her plank position, so that'd be one. You're like, not there. Drop the knees, find that nice knee plank first, so she's got the pelvis tucked in her hollow, she's pressing up through the shoulders, and then she lowers slightly forward and down with that knee push-up, again, maintaining that good hollow the entire time. You'll notice that we're comfortable. What hits first is the chest, not the hips, belly, and then the chest. She's lowering as one. So again, any type of push-up, rock those push-ups. You're going for max reps. It's not max set, all right? I want you to think about using the minute. Keep them clean. Just work on whatever you need to. Small set, shake it out, do a couple more. You don't have to worry about doing one big massive set, all right? And then not doing any more. Break them down. You have a minute, okay? So once you've done those three rounds of those on the minutes, you move directly into the next one, which is going to be a jumping lunge or a lunge. So we have lots of options for those lunges. So Raquel's just gonna do a couple forward lunges for us. So nice and tall on the torso, staying nice and stacked, knee, hip, shoulder. Nice and engaged, keeping that knee over top of the heel, all right? Another option is a back lunge, so she can step back, still focusing on that good, solid, upright torso, and that knee over top of the heel. If you're like, I don't lunge, all right? Then she can work on her single leg reach back. And so again, like we did in our warm up, working on that nice reach back, a little bit of lower, and then working on single leg balance. I don't have it with me right now, but you can do step ups as well, or what's called for the jumping lunge. So we're gonna get Raquel to do two jumping lunges, just kind of at her own pace. The position, from there, you do three rounds of that, and then you're done. All right? So lots of options, you guys. Make this workout yours, all right? Create the workset that's going to be best for you and get the best results for you. Remember the push-ups and the burpees. You have the full minute, so you don't have to worry about going super fast with them. Get good clean reps. Try and work for the whole minute with the burpees, perhaps, but try and keep those reps nice and clean, okay? Let me know how it goes, you guys. Post the results to it. Let me know what you chose for your push-ups, for squats, lunges, all that good stuff. This is an unloaded workout today, you guys. We did a lot of load throughout the week and yesterday, especially with our dumbbell DT variation. So keep this one fast, steady, and keep it unloaded so you guys can move really well today. All right, give the body a break from the load and have a fun body weight day. Okay? For now, happy birthday, Mike. Enjoy your day. Big thumbs up if you can. Big high five. Enjoy that workout, you guys.